What's up? Happy New Year! We're in 2019. But what's happening with this deal? It's like nobody knows what's going on with this deal. So shouldn't we talk about it? I don't think it's time to panic. Let's get into this news. I feel like Aphria is kind of panicking. I'm not gonna lie. I feel like they're in panic mode. I don't know. What do you guys think? Green Growth Brands got them where they want them. Green Growth Brands Inc. Green Growth Brands Inc. Let's talk about it, okay? So Green Growth Brands, GGB, GGBXF in America, reaffirms its commitment to launch an offer, the offer, to purchase all of the issued and outstanding shares of Aphria Inc., otherwise known as APHA on the Toronto Stock Exchange and APHA on the New York Stock Exchange, which it does not already own, and welcomes early expressions of interest from Aphria shareholders. Really? Who are frustrated. Look at this. Frustrated with Aphria's performance and absence of compelling future plans for the company. Really? Since we announced our intention to launch the takeover of Aphria, we have seen two things. First, Aphria shareholders are welcoming a 45% plus premium offer because they understand the significant value that can be unleashed by our combined teams, assets, and geographies. Second, a real interest in the market to understand green growth and our valuation. Interesting. This is very interesting. Peter Horvath, the CEO of Green Growth Brands, is a genius. When investors consider our trailing revenue, recent license wins in Nevada, and a bailout in the new market of Massachusetts. Sorry, a buildout in the new market of Massachusetts, they agree that it is not a question of if green growth reaches 7 per share Canadian, but when. Hear that? And the stock just keeps climbing, people. We understand that there are some in the market who want to focus on destroying value at Aphria, but we are committed to creating it. Interesting. He sounds more confident and effective at building Aphria than Aphria's own CEO, don't they? I find this quite interesting, this response by Green Growth Brands, and I wanted to talk about it because nobody's been talking about it. So like usual, I'm going to talk about it. Why Green Growth and Aphria are the right match. By acquiring Aphria, Green Growth represents a way for shareholders of Aphria to participate in the much larger U.S. market. Agreed. That's a very good point there. Oh, very good point there. With significant greater long-term sales potential, the combination of the two companies will create an unparalleled North American player with operations on both sides of the border, combining Aphria's Canadian supply and wholesale agreements with Green Growth's vertically integrated operations, including cultivation, manufacturing, and retail. The combination also marries the talent of Aphria's veterans in the greenhouse industry and pharmaceutical operations with Green Growth's team of retail experts from well-known retailers including Designer Shoe Warehouse Inc. and L Brands Inc., Victoria's Secret. Together, the combined company will be the largest U.S. operator by market capitalization and the only North American cannabis operator. Wow. I mean, that is pretty powerful. What do you guys think? I want to know what you guys think about this news. Please, guys, if you like this video, if you want me to continue to break this down for you, smash the like button, okay? Share the video everywhere. Comment down below, and not just in the comments of this live video, but when the video is published, please go in there, comment down below, guys. The more comments we get, the more viral the video gets, the more people see this video, the more people can comment on the video. I want to know what people think about this, because I still think there's a chance that this deal goes through. I do. I want to know your comments. Do you guys think there's a chance that this deal goes through? Yes or no? If yes, you think this deal goes through. If it's a no, you think the deal does not go through. I want to know. Can you guys comment? Yes or no? Please. I'd like to see what you guys think. And I'd also love to know where you guys are from. So maybe put like, yes, Toronto. No, Vancouver. Yes, Rhode Island. No, California. Yes, Germany. No, Philippines. I'd love to know. Let's make this a little interactive, guys. In the chat box, what do you guys think? Do you think this deal gets done? Yes. Do you think this deal does not get done? No. All right. Let's continue to break this down. Green Growth has a strong track record of success doing in months what has taken other cannabis companies years to achieve. Green Growth has a current fully diluted market capitalization of 1.1 billion Canadian. That is pretty impressive. I'm going to be honest with you. Very impressive. Wow. Infinite Possibilities believes the deal will go through. Interesting. And in Calgary. Thank you. Mike Affeld thinks the deal will go through as well. Unbelievable. So people believe this deal will go through. Another yes. That's three yeses in a row. I have yet to hear that one person doesn't think it's going to go through. Interesting. Management believes the additional value creation from the recent announcements and near-term business initiatives expected to be executed shortly have not yet been reflected in its share price and has confidence in a minimum $7 per share valuation for the following reasons. This is interesting. Now let's pull out Green Growth Brand so we can really look at this in detail, and we'll do this properly, right? We're going to do this properly. Wow. Oh, we got a no. So that's four yeses and one no. Very interesting. I believe last week most people thought this deal was not going to go through, but now that they have responded in kind, I don't know. This shows that they're very serious about this offer, and they are clearly speaking with shareholders within Aphria who are also interested in this offer because it's at a 45% premium. So let's take a look at the price of GGB in Canada, because this is what they're trying to say. They're trying to say that they are going to get to at least $7 Canadian, which is very interesting because they're currently at $4.65 Canadian. So they're still projecting a upside of $2.35, which is about 50% higher than these prices. That's pretty substantial. If they can do that, that's going to make this company even more attractive. Let's break down some of these statistics here. Green Growth has raised more than $150 million in capital since its inception in Canada in late 2018 when public by way of reverse takeover. Today, Green Growth owns, operates, and or licenses two premier retail cannabis stores under the banner The Plus Source, two as well as a cultivation and processing facility, all of which are located in Las Vegas, Nevada. The cultivation and processing facility comprises 12,000 square feet and has a potential annual capacity of 1,600 kilograms. Additionally, Green Growth, subject to regulatory approval, has an irrevocable purchase agreement to acquire a cultivation facility in Pahrump, Nevada. The Pahrump facility will be producing products in the near future. Green Growth was recently awarded seven, that's right, not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, not six, but seven additional licenses in Nevada for retail dispensaries, which together with its current operations and the power-up facility are expected to generate total revenue of $275 million by 2020. That's impressive. Green Growth has a first-to-market cannabinoidal CBD business. And you guys know I love CBDs. Green Growth recently announced the acquisition of Just Healthy LLC, which holds provisional certificates of registration for a registered medical marijuana dispensary in Northampton, Massachusetts, and a cultivation and processing site also located in Northampton. The license allows for up to three total medical dispensaries. Just Health LLC is expected to generate an incremental $130 million in revenue by 2020. That is Canadian. So the revenues just keep growing, and this is impressive. And I don't know if you knew this about Green Growth Brands, but this company is obviously on their way up. Green Growth has an extensive pipeline of value-creating initiatives and strategic partnerships, including working with six different large developers who represent a vast network of malls in the U.S. to launch over 450 mall kiosks in prime locations. Wow. Moreover, to illustrate confidence in the value of the $7 consideration Canadian under the offer, Green Growth expects to complete a concurrent brokered financing of 300 Canadian million at the same time per share price, with Green Growth insiders committing to backstop the entire financing. So these guys are making a serious play here for Aphria. I don't believe they are just joking around with this offer. At a $7 per share valuation, Green Growth value, and I mean, guys, look at this. If Green Growth goes up to $7 Canadian, we're all going to make a nice 50% from here if we decide to buy it. I want to know if you guys are interested in buying Green Growth. If you actually own Green Growth, I'd like to know that as well. Now remember, Rich TV Live is strictly for education and entertainment purposes. We are not licensed advisors. Always do your due diligence. Always do your research before you invest in anything that we talk about here on Rich TV Live. We will go through it. We will break it down. I am not trying to tell you to buy Green Growth Brands or Aphria whatsoever. Please do not get it twisted. I am simply educating you guys, breaking it down so that we can all understand what is happening here, and hopefully we can collectively make good decisions so we can all make money, okay? I want to make sure that we're all clear about that. At a $7 per share valuation, Green Growth would have a fully diluted total enterprise value of $1.6 billion. Based solely on Green Growth's current Nevada operations, the Parum facility, and Just Healthy LLC, Green Growth would trade at implied 12 times EBITDA, which is a discount of over 50% to current large cannabis peer multiples, which they're implying are trading at least 18 times revenue. Furthermore, factoring the value creation from its near-term business initiatives expected to be executed shortly, including mall kiosks, e-commerce, and wholesale, Green Growth would trade materially below the 12 times EBITDA. Aphria shareholders will continue to maintain control of the pro forma entity with 60% ownership. Green Growth shareholders will have a 34% ownership interest, with subscribers to the $300 million financing holding a 6% ownership interest. Green Growth is not a related party to Aphria. To our knowledge, Aphria does not own any shares of Green Growth, nor do any of Aphria's directors sit on Green Growth's board. As those who participate in the small yet growing cannabis industry know, there are many overlapping informal relationships between participants. Any informal relationship that may exist are separate from Green Growth's business decisions, and Green Growth has no related party influence with Aphria, nor does Aphria have a related party influence over Green Growth. They're making this very clear, okay? Because there have been some people and some whispers that there are some type of relations between the two parties. For further clarity, Aphria CEO Vic Neufeld, who is listed as one of many advisors to Green Acre Capital through its Green Acre Opportunity Corp fund, has no influence over green growth. Green Acre has invested in multiple cannabis entities, and many are considered competitors to Aphria. There is nothing noteworthy about Green Acre investing in another up-and-coming cannabis entity, regardless of overlap in a small emerging industry. The clearest evidence of lack of influence in Green Growth's acquisition of Aphria is in the fact Aphria's board has refused to engage and rejected Green Growth's premium offer, thus making a transaction much more difficult and expensive to achieve. So they approached the board with this offer and were rejected. And now they're approaching the shareholders. Misinformation from self-interest market participants does not change the merits of the premium offer. Certain market participants have spread misinformation related to green growth with its objective of destroying value in Aphria. This misinformation was generated by comments from those with a stated short position in Aphria. Once again, the short sellers. Isn't it funny how short sellers have their own invested interest and they love to put out misinformation so that they can benefit, even though it's hurting others? Benefiting themselves to hurt others, and that's allowed to be legal? It's interesting, right? And those trade will be impeded by Green Growth's premium offer. Shareholders should be aware of the facts related to a number of incorrect statements made specifically. Here we go. This is the specific statement that was made that they are saying is incorrect. Green Growth has confirmed the Scottenstein family does not own Aphria shares. The Scottensteins applied for a cultivation, processing, and dispensary license with an affiliate of Aphria, Liberty Health Sciences, in the state of Ohio. The venture was awarded a processing and dispensary provisional license in Ohio. At such time, the state law permits transfers. The JV, otherwise known as joint venture, will be dissolved. Subsequent to making the application in Ohio, Aphria divested its interest in Liberty Health Sciences. Sean Dim is not a director on Green Growth's board. Green Growth will launch its offer for Aphria. Green Growth has been willing to work with Aphria's board to find ways to enhance value for shareholders of both companies. Green Growth is confident in the certainty of a 300 million Canadian financing at $7 per share. Over 10% of Aphria shareholders have already indicated their support of the offer. Wow, that is interesting. Aphria's board has two options. Engage with Green Growth as a serious buyer to create real value, or continue their endless analysis, which will result in the destruction of shareholder value. Wow. Wow. We look forward to continued direct engagement with Aphria shareholders as we work together to build the leading cannabis company in the world. Wow. This is very interesting. This is a full intention to make an offer. This is not a joke. Look at this. About Green Growth Brands. Green Growth Brands expects to dominate the cannabis and CBD market. That's a pretty powerful term there. Dominate? With a portfolio of emotion-driven brands that people love, led by renowned retailer Peter Horvath, the GGB team is full of retail renegades. With decades of experience building successful brands, join the movement at greengrowthbrands.com. We're just going to quickly look at that, and we're going to look at Green Growth Brands, and we're going to look at Aphria. Now, what do you guys think? I think these guys are pretty serious. I don't know how Aphria cannot take this offer serious. They're offering them $11 Canadian. It's currently at $7.85. it's a 45% premium from these prices. So how could you not consider an offer that would give you more money than you're getting right now? Seems like a pretty good offer to me. I don't know what you guys think, but this is very serious. I believe that Green Growth Brands is a very, very strong company. I think that they are making a very strong offer. I believe they are going to be willing to negotiate more, further, maybe offer more as they grow as well. So I will keep you guys updated on everything that's happening. Please, guys, if you like this video, smash the like button. Comment down below, what do you think about Green Growth Brands and their bid to take Aphria and offer the shareholders $11 per share, a 45% premium from where they are trading right now. I mean, this company seems to be very, very confident in what they're doing. They have an amazing brand, obviously. They know all about branding. They are champion branders, clearly. And they've made a pretty serious offer here. Aphria is trying to say that the offer is not good enough, but what is Aphria doing to prove that this offer is not good enough? I don't see them doing anything. I don't know about you guys, but I think this offer is very serious, and I believe that there's a very good chance, I would say right now about 50-50, that this deal or some deal gets done with Green Growth Brands. What do you guys think? I'd like to know what you guys think. Please smash the like button if you like this video. Share the video everywhere. If I win and you win, we all win. It's true. Green Growth Brands looking to acquire Aphria. Aphria says it's not good enough. They don't feel this deal's good enough. But I think Green Growth Brands is making a pretty solid case. What do you guys think? Green Growth Brands reaffirms commitment to take over Aphria. All right, party people. Happy New Year's. Let's make 2019 the biggest year yet. Trading starts tomorrow. I'm out. Peace. Green Growth Brands trying to shock the world.